Stem cells for orthopedic joint pain. What is all the fuss about? What's the story? I'm Dr. Steve Meyers, and I'm a sports medicine physician, non-operative orthopedic physician. I've been practicing regenerative medicine since 2007. I added stem cells to my practice in 2014. So what are stem cells? Stem cells are cells within your body that have tremendous capability for healing. They can multiply, they can divide, they can become other kinds of tissue, including bone, tendon, ligament, cartilage, and even meniscus tissue. You can think of stem cells kind of like your body's healing system. These cells are throughout your body and go to areas of injury to help you heal. There are multiple sources of stem cells in your body. Most commonly, you can find stem cells in your bone marrow, and believe it or not, you can actually find stem cells in your fat. Your fat actually has 500 to 1,000 times more concentration of stem cells than your bone marrow does. Finally, something good to do with your fat. For most patients, getting stem cells from fat is the best choice. There's far more numbers of stem cells in your fat than there are in your bone marrow. But for certain patients, bone marrow may be the best option, particularly if you're very thin and do not have some fat to harvest, or if we need to inject cells directly into your bone. So I do want to explain the differences between getting stem cells from you versus stem cells from someone else. Using stem cells from you, there's no chance of rejection. It's your body's own tissue. It's important to understand that there are different sources for obtaining stem cells and regenerative medicine products for use in this current market. Stem cells from you contain live, active, healthy stem cells. However, if someone is giving you a stem cell procedure that they're calling a stem cell procedure, and they're getting the cells from someone else, whether it be from amniotic fluid, placental tissue, or umbilical cord, there have been multiple independent laboratories which have confirmed that none of those tissues contain live, active stem cells. The cells have actually died during the processing procedure, so you're getting a dead cell injection unless the cells are coming from your own body. A stem cell procedure is a very simple procedure we do right here in our clinic. It takes about 2 hours from start to finish. You're not put to sleep. We use local anesthetics only. We start off by numbing your skin around the belly area, or sometimes we have to go to the backside or flank to get tissue. We let that medicine sit for a few minutes, and then we come back and harvest a few tablespoons of fat tissue from your midsection or from your backside. We take this tissue back to the back of our office and process it, which involves cleaning the tissue, washing away the blood and the oils and the numbing medicine that I inject into you, and then we resize the tissue into 500 micron size particles, which we give back to you in the form of an injection. All of my injections are done under ultrasound guidance to precisely direct the cells right where they need to work within your body. The whole procedure takes about 2 hours, and you're able to drive yourself home in most instances, or you can have someone take you home. After procedure, the joints where we put the cells typically feel pretty good for a couple hours, and then things change. The joint will swell, it'll get stiff, tight, throbbing, aching, limping. What happens is you get this robust inflammatory response in the joint where we put the cells, and you'll feel it. So we put you on some pain medication for the first few days. Most patients are off the pain pill within 3 to 4 days. By 2 weeks, most patients are doing 95%. Of whatever activities they were doing before procedure. So the recovery is pretty quick. However, improvement takes time. Growing cells, healing tissue, doesn't happen overnight. This can take 2, 3, sometimes 5 months to see notable improvement with a stem cell procedure. So what kind of results are we seeing with stem cell? There's good published data out to 2 years on stem cell showing 60, 70, sometimes 80% improvement in pain and function. There are no long-term studies on stem cell at this point in time. It's very new, novel medicine. The long-term studies simply have not been completed, but there are good studies out to 2 years. And multiple studies have shown that you can actually increase cartilage volume in joints that have arthritis. In my practice, I'm typically seeing 85% success rate, defined as 50% improvement or better. 85% of my patients are getting at least 50% improvement in pain and function. Many are far more than that. I encourage you to visit my website. There's plentiful information regarding orthopedics and specifically stem cell. There is plenty of video testimonials of my own patients talking about their personal experiences with stem cell and their results. pick up the phone and call my staff. My staff is very knowledgeable with stem cell information, or simply come in and see me. I'd be happy to thoroughly evaluate your condition, talk to you about all the available options, including regenerative medicine and specifically stem cells, and together we can come up with a formula treatment plan that is best for you. If you're interested in stem cell and want to learn more, I encourage you to come to one of my seminars. I put on free educational seminars regarding stem cells right here in our clinic about once a month. The information can be found on my website for the dates and times. During the seminar, you'll learn all about stem cell. You'll learn about the published data that has been printed. You'll learn about how stem cells work and the processing that we do in order to perform a procedure. And you'll also have an opportunity to ask me personal questions about your individual condition.